4 minutes.
Right. Are the interceptors ready?
Yes, sir. We've been on red alert since 0600 hours.
If we do lose contact, you'll have to play it by ear.
Yes, sir.
3 minutes, Lieutenant.
It's a feeling of helplessness I can't take.
Sunspot activity is the perfect cover for UFOs. But do you think they'll try anything?
I think you can lay odds on it.
Give me the surface camera.
Yes, Lieutenant. 50 seconds. Interference ratio 2/7 increasing.
Interference level rising to critical, Commander.
Right. Well, it looks like we're going to have a communication blackout.
Sound of vision breaking up.
We'll keep the line open and test signal every 60 seconds. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. Give me the surface.
Minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Radar trace bearing 184, range 20 miles.
Camera 3. Launch the interceptors.
Interceptors, immediate launch.
Immediate launch.
Miles. Miles.
Congratulations to the interceptor pilots.
They didn't get near it.
What?
It disintegrated. No apparent reason.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Contact Paul Foster. And check on the next available lunar flight.
You're going up to moon base?
Yes. I want to know why a UFO gets within 4 miles of moon base, then destroys itself.
Those astronauts to get those aerial photos in here fast. That's the first thing he'll ask for.
The second thing, Space Tracker Harrington, the first thing is a cup of coffee. Perhaps you'll be good enough to organize that. Miss Barry.
Yes, sir?
I met your father about a month ago. I was happy to tell him I think you're settling in extremely well.
Thank you, sir.
Now, if you'd ask someone to bring the aerial photographs along to the leisure sphere, please.
Sir.
Oh, Harrington. That's with cream and sugar, please.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Mile 2 to control.
Yes, Commander.
We've completed the search in this area and can find no UFO wreckage.
Nor Conroy and Dale making out.
Well, they found a possible crash location, but nothing positive. They're out on the surface now, taking a closer look.
Roger, control out.
What are you hoping to find? If it did disintegrate in flight, the debris would have produced a large number of small craters over a wide area.
Yes, and the moon's surface has been pockmarked by millions of years of meteorites. Yes, I know that. But that UFO got within 4 miles of moon base, Paul. Perfect position to attack, and then it explodes. Why?
It's a good question. Let's hope Mobile One comes up with the answer.
Well, what do you think?
I don't know, it's hard to be sure.
Straker's gonna want to know.
You're in charge of this buggy, old son.
Thank you. Maybe the instrument recordings will tell us more. Let's get back to base.
Right.
Control to two.
Go ahead, Control.
Mobile One is about to dock.
All right. We're on our way back to out. Home, James, and don't spare the horses.
Hi, baby.
This is Control. Internal emergency. Internal emergency.
What's going on?
Where's Dale? What the hell have you done with Dale?
Andy.
Conroy.
How are you, Nina? Sit down.
Could have been worse. Nothing broken.
Do you feel like talking about it?
Well, sure. Conroy came into the control. He just stood there, staring. He looked bewildered and frightened, as if he didn't know where he was.
Well, what happened then?
Well, I asked him what's the matter, what's wrong, something like that.
Then?
Well, he struck out, and the girls tried to grab him. Everything happened so fast. He was very strong. Out of his mind. I'm sure he didn't know.
Didn't know what?
Who he was hitting. He just didn't know who we were.
Still at it, sir?
Yes, and it doesn't make any more sense now than it did 4 hours ago. Everyone who came into contact with Conroy reports more or less the same thing. Look at this. Berserk. Out of his senses. Didn't seem to recognize me. Fired at me indiscriminately with no reason at all.
Conroy's medical report of 3 weeks ago.
And?
Full clearance.
What about his stress factor?
98%, the near-perfect astronaut. He'd been in a couple of tight situations over the years, always kept his head, never been anywhere near cracking up.
Until now.
General quarters. General quarters. This is an internal security alarm. This is an internal security alarm.
Seal all exits. I want Captain Craig found and brought here. Use stun guns if necessary, but I want him alive.
Yes, sir.
What happened?
You tell me.
Look over there. He's not here. Come on.
Right.
Area 7.
What's taking so long?
We'll find him, sir.
Reception and embarkation area searched. Sleep sphere checked. Right. Move on to recreation area. Negative.
The explosive store's been broken into. Looks like a high detonation pack is missing.
Hold it, Craig. He's just entered the emergency exit 10,
wearing a spacesuit.
Order condition red.
This is control. Internal security, condition red. Repeat, condition red.
If he gets near the air and water installations with that explosive pack. Why wasn't exit 10 sealed?
It's an emergency exit, sir. It remains operational even during an alert.
All right. Get some men out there after him.
Yes, sir.
And I want to check on all emergency air supplies.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and find out where he got that spacesuit.
Right away, sir.
There's a spacesuit missing from the legisphere, but he won't get far.
It was due for recharging. There's practically no air left in the pack.
Scan the surface.
Yes. There he is.
We have no choice. Use number 4.
Have to use a missile.
No. It's too close to our installation.
Listen to me, Craig. We know what you're trying to do, but it's 200 yards to that air and water installation. You'll never make it.
I'll be close enough.
Lieutenant Craig, we realize you want to destroy Moonbase, but you're destroying yourself. Your air supply won't last.
Systems checked and okayed, sir.
Right. Oh, stand down to yellow.
Yes, sir. The damage report, sir.
Thank you.
This is control. Stand down to internal condition, yellow.
Well, there's nothing here we can't handle.
Thank you, sir.
What now?
Well, I'm going back to bed.
Aren't you interested to find out what happened?
It'll keep. No one's going anywhere, are they, Colonel?
Give me a teleprinter link to Earth. I want to make a report.
Yes, Colonel.
Colonel Freeman?
Yeah?
I have a communication for you, Colonel.
Well?
It's a somewhat unusual channel.
Well, all right, Lieutenant, what is it?
General Henderson wants to see you right away.
He contacted you?
One of his assistants did.
Well, why not Miss Eland? She usually deals with personal calls.
I was a little surprised myself. Anyway, I was asked to give the message only to you. And you're asked not to communicate it to anyone.
Anyone? Does that include Commander Straker?
Commander Straker was specifically mentioned, sir.
I see.
That's what he said.
I appreciate it, Alec. I'm not going to say they shouldn't have told me.
Good. So what's it all about?
Why don't you go along and see Henderson and find out?
Well, you're wondering why I asked you here.
More than that, I'm wondering about the way you asked me here.
You mean my request that you should tell no one about your visit?
I mean the fact that I was asked not to tell Commander Straker.
And did you?
First chance I got.
Told me just a month ago that Foster would do a thing like this. I
forget it, Alec.
What do you mean, forget it?
Listen, Foster didn't transmit that information to General Henderson out of pure malice. There's got to be another reason for it.
Has there?
He's bucking for promotion, and he doesn't care who he has to step on to get it.
Well, there's only one way to find out the answer. Tackle him about it. Thanks, Alec.
Girls, go and grab a cup of coffee. All right, Paul. who sent details of the new appropriation request to General Henderson.
That's right.
At best, that was a serious breach of trust. What are you trying to pull, Foster?
Stop you spending millions on moon bases for a start.
You should know better than anybody that a mass attack is on the cards.
Speculation.
Half this job is speculation. It must be.
Yes, and it's proving pretty expensive.
In the past 4 months, there has been a marked fall-off in UFO sightings.
Which proves that our present equipment is more than adequate.
Maybe. Or maybe it indicates a grouping. A grouping for a much larger operation. It's going to come. I want to be ready.
I think you're wrong.
I don't care what you think. I didn't come in here to discuss the appropriation. I want to talk about your future with this organization.
Are you firing me?
No. Nobody gets fired from Shadow. Your report to General Henderson was an inconvenience. I can ride that out. No. You're free to express your right of criticism of this command. But you are not free to divulge information given to you in confidence.
And if I do? All right. Let's get one thing clear. I stick to my opinion. I'm gonna push for a change of command.
How hard will you push, Paul? As hard as Craig?
You still say he tried to kill you?
Yes.
With an empty hypodermic.
What did you say? I've told no one how he tried to kill me. An air bubble in the blood. Lethal. And very difficult to prove the cause of death. Open it.
No use, Commander. The doorway's sealed. We won't be disturbed.
Must be a short circuit someplace.
Get the emergency power switched on and trace the fault.
Right.
Colonel, why don't you just think about this?
Think about it.
We're switching to the emergency power circuit. Emergency power circuit now in operation.
You're crazy, Foster. You know that, don't you?
Am I?
You must be to think you'll get away with this.
You run this organization too long, it's as simple as that. All right, Foster.
What do you plan to do?
You came into the control sphere.
You asked the girls to leave and lock the doorway.
You tried to talk me back into line. I refuse. You started throwing insults. There was a fight. You lost control and pulled a gun. Your gun, Commander. I got it from your locker. I managed to jump you. There was a struggle.
And the gun went off accidentally.
I've got it in one.
If we bypass the damage circuit, we can link into the emergency supply.
Right.
And I want a couple of men outside immediately.
Yes, Lieutenant.
Thank you.
to use it. Makes no difference. That shot punctured the sphere. We're losing air. This is the end, Straker.
Is it?
If you don't pass out, I'll kill you with your own gun.
Guess you try and get it.
Well, I won't have to. You'll pass out before I will. That's it. Fight it. I can wait. You see, it's a question of physique. I'm younger, fitter, stronger.
You're forgetting one thing, Foster. Willpower.
We've bypassed the circuits.
Okay. Stand by.
The door should be open in 1 minute.
We'll be in the area in 8 minutes. We're in position.
Do we have trouble?
I don't think so.
But we have an unidentified radar trace.
Yes.
Then something's there.
I guess so, but...
And it could be that UFO.
It's practically stationary.
The point is, do we have a UFO on our hands or don't we?
Well, in my opinion, it's a million to one against. But of course, we'll maintain a full alert radar track.
No. Launch Sky One. Tell Waterman to investigate.
Yes, sir.
This is Shadow Control to Skydiver.
Launch Sky One, investigate possible UFO. Position 012302, Red 3.
Roger Control, out. Launch stations.
Launch stations. Check circuits.
HP circuits okay. Relays okay.
Okay for launch, Captain.
Liftoff stations.
Liftoff stations.
Check boosters.
Checking boosters.
We still have positive track.
Green on three. Confirm radar fix.
Control to Sky One. New position, 018294. Range 25 miles.
I have it on internal radar.
Should have visual contact in about a minute. I think I can see it. Panic over. It's a weather balloon.
That's why I picked you up myself. I wanted to brief you before you had a word with General Henderson.
Well, I knew it wasn't for my big blue eyes.
Coming back from the moon can be disorientating. Even moon speeds have some effect on time.
Yes, sir. I see, sir. Never knew that, sir.
What's that?
What?
Thought I saw something up there.
Cars on dark country roads can be disorientating, too.
There is something up there. 15 degrees west. There, see?
It's Venus.
Wrong direction.
Space shop?
No, we have none scheduled.
Could be a Russian launch.
No, we have their schedule too. Space debris.
No, it's the wrong pattern. Well, all I've got left is a weather balloon. That would mean it's drifting against the wind.
It's a UFO. Straker to Shadow Control. UFO in Earth's atmosphere coming your way. Do you read me? Do you read me? Check the radio link.
But how could it have got past moon base without being spotted?
I don't know.
Well, the radio checks out. We're receiving and transmitting at full strength.
It's absurd. Why doesn't control answer?
Well, it's not this end. They landed to destroy the base.
They may have done just that.
How long?
About another 10 minutes.
It's coming this way.
sorry. I just don't seem to be able to remember a thing.
You can't remember coming back with Commander Straker?
I can recall leaving the airport in Commander Straker's car, but after that, nothing, I'm afraid.
Yes, it was a severe blow to the base of the neck.
Don't I know it?
Are you okay?
Over the tires! Ahead of the human race, but we've got one thing they haven't. Bloody-mindedness. It built this planet. Miss Eve. Base reacted. They must know something's wrong. They could have had Skydiver over the base by now.
What are you gonna do?
Call General Henderson. We need help. That thing's still up there. If it comes down before we can get assistance, must be someone we can contact. It's no use. Just understand the principle they've used. There's no pulse.
The body temperature's normal.
Yet they're fixed like statues.
It's almost as though they'd be frozen in time.
Yes, that's it. That way, whatever they were doing, they'd be fossilized when the force struck.
Yet the lift from your office was working.
Yes, I know. It doesn't fit the pattern. This isn't frozen. They have one thing in common.
They weren't in motion when it happened.
Yes, they weren't moving in time. That's why the elevator works.
But then if we could find a monitor that wasn't switched on.
No, they were all switched on. There's got to be an answer. We just have to think it through.
I don't seem to be able to think anymore. God, I feel so tired. I feel as though I could sleep for a week.
Yes, I know. It must be shock catching up with us. Wait a minute. Let me see your watch.
We got to the studio.
Just like the clock. Beginning to get to us.
Yes. I can feel it.
Medical center.
travel so fast. Cheap time.
Sound barrier. Heat barrier. Light barrier. Time barrier.
They can control it. But only for so long. Until the field force they built up on the way here begins to wear off. Like the waves of pressure you see in front of an airplane.
That's why they haven't landed yet. They're still in a different continuum.
Yes. Well, they obviously have to shed the field force before they can operate here.
But why? How are they reaching us?
I don't know. Maybe we'll find out some answers when we get back to the control room. Are you okay?
Fine.
Come on, let's go.
What is that stuff?
X-50. It speeds you up to 10 times normal. Heart, muscles, brain, coordination. They use it a lot in the early high-G test flights. Finally banned it as being too dangerous.
Why?
Well, it burned people out. If we weren't under the evil eye now, we'd be moving so fast we'd just be a blur. But the room is lead-lined, Colonel. It's built to resist any known force field.
Commander.
What is it?
On the corridor. I'm sure I saw something move.
Transistor microphone. Somewhere over there to the right. Behind that wall. You stay here. Now cover me. J and K stages. He's over on one of the sound stages.
Oh, Look.
Slowing down. Drugs. Hypodermic. You use too much energy.
What will another shot do to you?
Doesn't matter. Quick. The Molly. It's our last chance.
Shouldn't I have another shot? It was dangerous, wasn't it?
I made my choice a long time ago. Take that key. Put it in there. Hang on to this.
You get very quiet about it.
It's that old bloody-mindedness. Can you hold on?
Shall I get another one of these?
No, there's no point. We're not gonna get a second chance. We miss with this first one, they'll fry us.
What's their range?
Well, we have to wait till they get in close. Turner.
Come and get it, Commander. You're out of your league, Straker. The nearer they come, the more power they transmit to me. I can play time like a trumpet now. You primitive idiot. You can only see me where I've just been, or where I'm going to be. Not where I am, unless I want you to. You'll lick, Straker!
Where did you come from?
Nobody's to come through that door. Nobody. Understand?
Open the door! Let us through! Get the door open, Miss Eden! Come on!
It's all right, Commander, it's all right.
Now try. Try and rest.
Incredible.
Yes, General. But there are more things.
But how?
I'm not sure, but in some way they were able to expand a moment in time. Commander Straker experienced such an extended moment.
Missile timing, 1-4-7-5.
Missile program completed.
Turn complete, sir.
Commence second run.
We have a radar trace, sir.
Bridge.
We have a radar trace, sir.
Bearing 147, speed Mach 5, reducing fast.
Mr. Kubam.
Sir?
Can you see anything?
No, sir. Yes. Yes, there. What is it, sir?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like this before. It's coming down. Action stations.
Thank you.
The tracking...
Sighting confirmed. Course varying 8 to 10 degrees.
Get moon base.
Right.
Hello, Gay. How long has it been banking and weaving like this?
It started 2 minutes 20 seconds ago, sir. Before that, course and speed were constant.
What were the readings?
Course 037164. Speed sol 1.6.
Never had a flight pattern like this before.
Course still varying. Speed now 0.85 and reducing.
Thank you. How long before Commander Straker comes on duty?
What's the panic?
A UFO. Its approach is much slower than usual, and it's varying course constantly.
Yes, but maintaining an overall flight path. Yes, I agree with you, Alec. This zigzagging is unusual.
It's almost as if it were trying to avoid something.
Or find something. Well, we can't take any chances. Sound a red alert for all ground stations.
Shadow control to all stations. We have a red alert. Repeat. Condition is red.
Interceptors, immediate launch.
Immediate launch.
Stand by to set missile control computer.
Right.
Missile timing, 1, 4, 7, 5.
Missile launch, 10 seconds.
Positive. Contact lost.
Moon base to Shadow Control.
We hit it, Commander.
Well done, Lieutenant. Oh, that one certainly made a new approach. I wonder what it was trying to do.
We'll never know, I'm glad to say.
Cigar?
Thank you.
Moon base to Shadow Control.
What is it, Lieutenant?
I have another contact, sir.
A second UFO?
No, sir. The same one.
The same one? But you reported a positive detonation.
I know, sir. The scanners showed negative.
But it's back.
Well, what's the position now, Lieutenant?
I'm sorry, sir. It's through moon base defenses.
Heading for Earth.
Thank you.
Can't understand how those interceptors missed. Seemed to me that UFO was a sitting target.
Maybe that's what we were supposed to think.
And that's a good point, Alec. Force the interceptors to release their missiles, avoid them, then it gets a clear run past the moon base defenses. Where is it now?
Range 7 million.
Trajectory termination?
It's difficult to say. It's changing course more violently than before. Nearest we can get is Western Europe.
Well, it could be damaged. Lieutenant Ellis reported a strike.
Speed increasing. 1.4. 1.8. 2.4.
That does it. We'll never get near it at that speed. Must get a closer ETT.
Is the rate of descent constant? More or less. There's still a slight variation.
It should be possible to work out a broad target area.
We'll try, but our readings are less than adequate, computer data.
Do your best, Lieutenant. Looks like it's going to hit. The question is, what is it up to?
Tell you what I think, Alec. I think that UFO is under manual control. First, the flight variation was used to disrupt our computer programs.
But now I think the alien is fighting to regain control.
Well, that makes sense. If it's damaged.
Yes. The next few minutes are going to be very interesting.
Trajectory termination. Areas 17 to 23.
Too close for comfort. Sound a red alert.
So. Four
017422. Lieutenant?
ETT, area 17, map reference 405, green.
Tracer.
Bridge.
We've picked up a radar trace. Bearing 281. Mach 5. Reducing.
Action stations. Gun crews on immediate standby. Repeating, gun crews on standby. Missile in position, sir. Launch missile, Mr. Cooper.
Clear for firing. Clear for firing.
Get that missile launched, Mr. Cooper.
Bridge to missile control. Fire. Repeat. Fire. It's the damage, officer, sir. Missile guidance electronics have been affected by the explosion. They're still trying to ascertain the damage.
What the blaze has happened?
It's no use, sir. Missile systems are negative.
Alert gun crews.
Bridge to gun, stand by. Bridge to gun, stand by.
There it is.
Puts it out of range, sir.
One more shot. Maybe two. That's all.
What the devil's that?
Thank you.
Survivors, some evidence of UFO.
So it must be that UFO that came in a month ago under a radar blind spot.
And if it stayed underwater, it would escape deterioration in the Earth's atmosphere.
It could even have slipped in a special underwater craft in component sections.
Possibly. They seem to have perfected life maintenance in a liquid environment.
Right. So what do we do next?
A detailed search of the entire area. I'll go myself.
In Skydiver?
What else?
Well, wouldn't you rather I took over?
Oh, that. Well, the dictionary defines it as a morbid dread of confined spaces. Skydiver's not all that small.
And you're not always morbid.
Exactly.
Get me Skydiver's positional chart.
Yes, sir.
It's in the South Atlantic area, about 400 miles south of St. Helena.
Cabin is at your disposal.
Thank you, Captain.
Do you think we'll find anything?
Well, it's hard to say. But the more I think about it, the more the theory stands up. Well, we know they've taken people from houses in broad daylight.
You mean it'd be a lot easier mid-ocean?
Right.
It's a big place to play cat and mouse.
Yes, but we'll just have to make sure that our claws are well sharpened.
How do you mean?
Well, we're trying to find them. Let's hope that the aliens don't think that we're the mouse.
Approaching B-17, sir.
Right, plot a search pattern.
Yes, sir.
Lieutenant?
Sir.
I want a constant radar sweep and sonar sounding.
Yes, sir.
Straker.
We're making the first sweep on the surface, sir.
And we'll be going under for a submerged circuit.
Right. Carry on, Captain.
Let's make the most of the fresh air.
Thank you.
Starting vector search.
Course 019, veering to 023. Decreasing sweep on 14 degrees port.
Right.
Maintain the watch, Colonel. I'm going below.
Right.
How's it going, Nina?
Fine, sir.
What is it?
Large shoal of fish. Sonar is our best bet.
Well, you're the expert.
Tight ship, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Sonar echo increasing.
What do you make of it, Lieutenant?
Metallic object. I'm moving quite fast. 60 knots.
How far?
2,000 yards increasing.
Get below, Colonel. I'm taking you down.
Dive! Dive! Dive!
What is it?
An underwater craft, sir. Moving ahead of us.
Altering course. Veering to starboard. Eight degrees
starboard. Switch on underwater cameras.
Visibility poor, sir. Rock formations. We've lost it.
Rocks don't help.
Right surface.
Float tanks 1 and 2.
Blowing 1 and 2.
Malfunction on 1.
Keep trying those tanks. Hold it! Shut down ballast.
It's heading away, toward the surface.
Can we launch Sky One?
We can try.
All right, Paul.
It's no good.
What's its attitude?
10 degrees.
It's enough. Launch Sky One.
Lift off.
Roger.
Sky One airborne, sir. Sky under control. Come in, skydiver.
Contact lost, sir.
We're going down. Turbine's non-functional.
Shut down the reactor.
Yes, sir.
Prepare to switch to emergency power.
We're still going down.
Emergency power. Crash positions.
Control. Overflying last known position. Still no radio contact. Wreckage apparent. Redocking negative.
Roger, Sky One. Proceed to nearest shadow base. Starting sub-smash procedure.
Roger.
Get to it. Colonel Foster, the air systems and electrics.
Sir.
Albatross 2-5 to Shadow Control. We have positive area location on Skydiver Beacon. Homing on signal now.
Roger, Albatross.
Another 50 minutes. What do you think?
No way of telling, sir. Sub-smashes are always difficult.
I better check things out in the cabin.
Officer?
Sir. We'll be there in less than 50 minutes. What do you think their chances are?
Hard to say. By the time we get there, it could be sitting on the surface, waiting for us.
That's not likely, is it? Wreckage.
Till we get there, sir. It's anyone's guess.
Nearly through here, Commander.
How are things astern?
Not good. One turbine completely blown, and there's some damage to the reactor cooling plant.
Well, that means we can forget the main power supply.
How about the air supply, Paul?
Well, it's impossible to be accurate, but I estimate there's enough air for 8 hours. About the same as the batteries.
Lieutenant Lewis, I hope you got some good news for us on those escape hatches.
Well, there's only one of them operational, sir, number 3 hatch. And that's got trouble.
Wait, it's working, but the systems check indicates damage. In addition, there's something wrong with the pumps. I reckon it'll take upwards of 90 minutes to empty that hatch.
One escape hatch in commission, and that's only usable every 90 minutes.
What about the missile tubes?
Oh, no go, Commander. The ship's angle rules them out. The rock ledge is blocking the exits.
See what you can do about fixing up those pumps, and double check on those hatches.
Get any more speed out of this thing?
Not without blowing our engines to pieces. You know Commander Straker pretty well, don't you?
Yes. Pretty well. Paul?
We've checked it again, sir. It looks pretty bad.
Well, we'll have to start making for the surface. Now, we've got to phase this pretty carefully. We're working with very little air and practically no time.
I'm a bit worried about the outer door on 3. There's indication of severe damage.
What about the pumps?
Well, still no improvement. With the reactor off, the power's very low. What do we tell the crew?
Forget it. They've figured it out for themselves already.
Now don't worry, Nina. We'll get out all right.
You've been in this situation before, haven't you?
Yeah. Yeah, it was a big boat. Full crew, 69 men trapped on the bottom, but we all got out. And we will this time, too.
All right. Let's go over the situation. Now, there's only one regular escape hatch still working, but its pumps are damaged, as well as its outside door. But there is another emergency escape route through the crash dive flood tube. We can only use it once. But it means that two of us will get out immediately. But if it takes 90 minutes to empty the hatch each time, we can all be out of here in 4.5 hours.
You said 4.5 hours, Commander, but at best the air can last only...
You're forgetting one thing, Lieutenant. The fewer people there are down here, the longer the air will last.
Have you decided...
Lieutenant Barry, you will use the crash dive tube.
Yes, sir.
Lewis?
Sir?
You'll have first crack at the escape hatch.
But, sir...
That's an order. And then Colonel Foster. All right, let's get to it. The crash dive tube is the safest way out, but it won't be easy. When we throw the control and the water comes in, it'll hit you like a sledgehammer.
Yes, sir, I know. I used it once during training.
Good, good. It'll only last for a second, and then you'll be okay.
I'll manage.
Right, well, the sooner you get out of here, the more air it'll be for the rest of us.
There's no chance of our surface vessel getting to the area ahead of us.
Forget it. She's 5 hours away. We're on our own.
Well, there's only a slight swell. We'll be able to handle it.
All set.
Good. Synchronized watches. 15:50.
Check.
Check.
Now we'll blow the hatch in 5 minutes, Lieutenant. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. See you topside.
Hatch flooded, sir. Check. It's opened. He's made it.
Nina should be in position now. Prepare to detonate in 20 seconds. Ten seconds. Detonate.
Well, they should be up by now.
Thank you. Straker.
Ed, it's me.
Alec. Thank God.
We've got Lewis.
What did you say?
I said we've got Lewis. He's quite safe. He's explained the situation. Now look, Ed, just hang on.
Alec, have you got Nina?
Nina? No.
She went out right after Lewis.
Well, don't worry. Don't worry. We'll get her. We'll find her. Look, Ed. You've got to conserve your air supply. Now just rest and stay as quiet as possible. The divers are coming down now. They'll get you up.
Alec. Alec.
They're slowing down. You know, death's never worried me before. Right now, I'm scared.
You're getting older.
How do you mean?
The older you get, the more precious life becomes. You become aware of what life is.
Moving.
But, sir...
Colonel Foster, get off this boat.
Commander.
You're breathing my oxygen. In you go. How does it look?
She's jammed fast, sir. The only certain way of moving her is by heavy lifting gear, but we need the salvage vessel for that.
Is there any way we can get an air supply down there?
Negative. I was hoping to use the escape hatch, but it's still flooded.
The pumps must have packed up completely.
hopeless.
You'll have to go down there again. And get me a suit, will you?
Sir. What are you going to do?
I don't know. But we're going to get him out of there somehow. It's okay.
We're sending them down now.
Right. And send down some more lights.
Right.
Had to be anyone. I'm glad you're here. I mean, I'm glad it's you.
Believe it.
So that's the way it happened.
You mean to say you just blew us out of the water?
Well, what else could we do? Holden came up with the idea.
And with Skydiver off the ledge, the divers got in through the missile tubes.
And that's the way it happened.
I'm afraid the visitors will have to leave now. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. No smoking.
Well, back to the salt mines.
Bye.
Oh, thanks for the cigars, Alec. Well, Nina, we were pretty close down there.
Yes. If there was anything I said which, well...
Or didn't say? That's what life's all about, I guess. The things we never say. Well, they're kicking me out of here this afternoon. I better go and pack my toothbrush. You'll be back on Moonbase in a week or so.
Yes, sir.
Take it easy, Nina.
Bye.